name is Dana.
My name is Suren.
Suren, do you know a lot about English writers and their poems?
No, only a little.
That's why, for you and for other our children, we have chosen the subject of our meeting, the English poetry.
First of all, I would like to introduce you to our respectable jury, Mrs. Kadoskina.
Mrs. Bastakova.
Mrs. Stoda.
Mrs. Abramenko.
And the chief of our jury, Mrs. Tikhomirova.
Okay, let's start. Today our students have chosen the poems of the English writers and they decided to introduce them to us.
William Shakespeare, often called the English national poet, is widely considered the greatest dramatist of all time. The famous writer was born on April 26, 1564, in Stratford-on-Avon. All of us know his greatest tragedies, Hamlet, Othello, Romeo and Juliet, and others.
But except them, we know a lot about his sons, and our students decided to show them us. Maria Moskalenko, 8-4, sonnet number 55.
Sofia Genkina, 6-4, sonnet number 35.
William Shakespeare, sonnet number 55. Not marble, nor the gilded monuments of Greece shall outlive this powerful rhyme, but you shall shine more bright in this concert than unsought stone was mirrored in this lavish time. While best for martial statues of adorned and bronze through towers of rock of masonry, no mask is forged, no mask with fire shall burn the living record of your memory. Against death and all of Libya's energy shall you pace forth, your praise shall still find you, even in the eyes of all posterity that wears this will down to the ancient dream. So, till the judgment of yourself arise, you live in peace and dwell in God's eyes.
Sofia Genkina, 6-4.
Sonnet number 35. No more be grieved, and that the shell has done. Roses have forms, and so the form is in the mind. Clouds and eclipses, they of moon and sun. And loves of again, this is the city's part. All men make faults, and even I am this. Presence that your space was not well, myself perhaps in seven minutes. Excusing thyself more than they seem thine, for to thy essential fault I bring in sense, that is best part in thy advocate, and gives myself a love of my comments.
Since she will war in my love and hate.
Then accessory youth must meet the sweet fig which sorrowly robs from me.
Robert Burns was born in Scotland in 1759 in the family of hard-working farmer. Our Russian poets like to translate the poetry by Burns, especially Samuel Marshall. There are a lot of poems by Burns translated into Russian. His fellow countrymen say that our country is the second homeland.
Alexander Twardowski told, Samuel Marshall made Burns Russian, leading him to Scotch. Vera Nikitina, 8-4, My Heart in the Highlands.
My heart's in the Highland by Robert Burns. My heart's in the Highland, my heart is not here. My heart's in the Highland, is chasing the deer, is chasing my wild deer and falling the rope. My heart's in the Highland, wherever I go. Farewell to the Highland, farewell to the north, the birthplace of Poland, the country of war. Wherever I wander, wherever I rough, the hills of the Highland, wherever I love. Farewell to the mountains that covered with snow, farewell to the fields and green valleys below, farewell to the forests and wild hanging woods, farewell to the torrents and low clearing flutes. My heart's in the Highland, my heart isn't here. My heart's in the Highland, is chasing the deer, and chasing my wild deer and following my rope. My heart in my heart, wherever I go.
Вячеслав Борисов, 84, My Red Red Rose.
A red rose by Robert Burns. My love is like a red red rose that's newly strung in June. My love is like the melody that's sweetly played in tune. As fair art thou, my bonny lass, so deep in love am I, and I will love thee still, my dear, till as the seas get dry. Till as the seas get dry, my dear, and the rocks melt with sun, and I will love thee still, my dear, while the sands of life shall run. And far thee will, my only love, and far thee will, a while, and I will come again, my love, till it were 10,000 miles.
Dana, do you know anything about Algernon Charles Swinburne?
Nothing.
I'm sure not only you. Okay, listen to me. Algernon Charles Swinburne was born in London in 1837. More than anything, he liked to write poems, and all his time he spent on it. He has very nice poem, Swan Song. Our pupil from the eighth form has chosen it, maybe because she is dancer and she is like swan.
Ксения Чебанкова, eighth form, Swan Song.
Swan Song, why not show of sorrow, and joy is never sure. Today will die tomorrow, cap stoops to moments lie. And love, faint and fretful, with lips but half regretful, sighs the eyes forgetful, lips but no less urgent. From too much love of fear, from hope and festive glee, with them we live thanksgiving, whatever gods will be. That no love is forever, that judgment rises never, that even the very stream leads somewhere but safe to see.
Why are we speaking only about English poets? There are a lot of English poets too. For example, Elizabeth Barrett Browning. She was born in 1806 in the family of West Indian plantator. She became very popular in 1850 when her poems about love were published. Now, Stas Bishenkov, 84.
What is the best thing in the world? June rose, I meet you in belt. Sweet sounds sweet, that means no rain. Truth and cruel to a friend. Pleasure, not in haste to end. Ma'am, beauty, not so deep and cool. Till it's bright is over there. Light that never makes you blink. Memory that gives no pain. Laugh when so we are laughed again. What is the best thing in the world? Something out of it, I think.
Mark Twain, American poet, the son of the rich manufacturer, he was sure that he was a great loser against his father's success. In 1829, he made a suicide. He was only 29. I can't explain why Alexandra Garov from the 8th form has chosen this poet, but maybe because Sasha is a romantic person.
That freed from need and measure wanders. Forgetfulness is like a bird whose wings are in silent, outspread and motionless, a bird that crosses the night unwarily. Forgetfulness is rain at night, or an old house in the forest, or a child. Forgetfulness is white. White as a blasted tree, in it we stand as a signal into prophecy, or where is the gods?
I can remember much forgetfulness. You know, many Russian poems were translated into English. and today we decided to present you one of such poems. Сергей Есенин, the greatest Russian poet. He was born in 1895 in Константиново. In 1912 he moved to Moscow and his first poetry appeared in Moscow journals in 1914. His life was very short, he lived only 30 years. Up to now we don't know the reason of his death exactly. Алексей Даренко, 84.
I don't sorrow, I don't weep or cover. All will pass like apple blossoms more. With the god of autumn tied in my soul, and my young can never be revolved. My poor heart already touched with shell, will not keep up its excited beer. And the water lamp of bucking chains will not be removed my cap and my back. And my rest is less, less often. Stirs me up to keep my back on swell. Now the thing, the violin has softened. And the freshness of motion is once again.
Emily Elizabeth Dickinson was an American poet and she was born in 1830. She wasn't recognized in her own time and she became very popular after her death. Ольга Костачева from the 10th form decided to present us her poem.
You know the pirate in the moon, so tell me who is lying. Very proud, a stubborn eye, the hope for safety's sake. The very bad and all the cheek, the very sin the cheek. The isthmus sits very long, and fashion into when. When moon says, who is the soup, I say, my lips just hold the name. Impression through I warn I know, but there's the God and say. And when some night will slashing clouds can see away from me, it's easier than the other thing in places like it.
Robert Lee Frost, famous American writer, was born in San Francisco in 1863. The main idea of his writer's poems is the country reality of New England. His lovely hero is a farmer from New Hampshire. Екатерина Пахомова from 10th form will read the poem, Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening.
Those woods is hard. I think I know his house is incalculable. But I will not see me stopping here to see his woods fill up the snow. My little horse might think it's queer to stop without a farmhouse near. Within the woods, in frozen lake, the darkest demon companion. He gives his harness bells a shake and asks, there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of his wind and down the flame. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep, and miles to go before I sleep.
Some poems which they have chosen are very fun and I think we will enjoy ourselves together.
Сергей Мушников, Days in the Month.
So today has September, April, June and November. February has 28 alone. All the rest has 31, but leap year coming once in four. It's February, one day more.
Anna Nikitina, three Christmas wishes.
If I had three Christmas wishes, my first wish would be for an end to hunger and poverty. If I had three Christmas wishes, my second wish would be for an end to violence, hatred, and war. If I had three Christmas wishes, my third wish would be that we take proper care of the land and the sea.
with her poems Greatest Time.
Thank you. them, and one for the little boy who looked down the lake. Bleh, 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 sheep. Have you any wool? Yes, sir, 3 bags full. Bleh, bleh. Why, sheep? Have you any wool? Yes, sir, 3 needles full. 1 to my jumper, 1 to my frock, and 1 to little girl with holes in her socks. Bleh, bleh. Brown sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, 3 bags full. 1 for the kittens, 1 for the cat, and 1 for owner, you need some woolen hats. Bleh, bleh. Rain, sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, 3 bags full. 1 for the daddy, 1 for the man, and 1 for the little baby who lives down the lane. Where, sheep, have you any wool? No, sir, no bags full. No for the daddy, no for the man, and no poor little baby go down the lane.
Time to make their conclusion, and then they will tell us who is the best reader.
Вы знаете, жюри так оказалось в таком затруднении, причем затруднение у нас были некие такие сравнительные характеристики старших и младших классов. Как неудивительно, но в пользу младших. Поэтому мы подумали, так где-то посовещались и пришли к единодушному мнению. Скажем так, за участие в таком празднике, за то, что познакомили нас с удивительной поэзией Бернса, Шекспира, мы награждаем 8-й класс и 10-й класс дипломами за участие в этом конкурсе. Это дипломы мы сейчас подпишем, я потом поставлю печать, и вы сможете их разместить в своих классных уголках. Поскольку это ваше достижение в иностранном языке, в английском языке. Тем не менее, мы решили выделить среди участников 8 и 10 класса 2 человек. Первое место, скажем так, и поощрительный приз занимает Александр Горох со стихотворением Харта Крейда «Беспамятство». Среди десятых классов, пожалуй, свою благодарность мы выражаем Екатерине Пахомовой, которая справилась с достаточно сложным произведением Роберта Ли Фостера. Это нам приз, диплом, если можно, я поставлю печать, и когда принесу в класс, обязательно вручу. Спасибо вам большое, спасибо. Ну, а теперь про пятые. Пятые у нас, конечно, здорово, прямо скажем, выступили. Я уж не говорю там, с какими презентациями, с какими музыками и так далее, и так далее. Но вы знаете, что хотелось бы в первую очередь отметить? Это творческое отношение их. И на первое место, конечно, выходят сразу 3 человека. Это Иван Маркеев, я начну. Наш Александра Маркова и Никита Мафитовна. Еще раз аплодисменты юному. Это не значит, что остальные пятиклассники плохо выступили. На самом деле мы тут столько писали. Просто у этих троих уже не только произношение, но и проглядывается интонация, английская интонация, да, не наша, когда мы читаем а английская интонация. Ну уж не говоря о том, что артистичность у них была самая заметная. Но остальным пятиклассникам тоже большое спасибо. Вы отдельный диплом получите, я только поставлю вам часть, хорошо, и это вручим вам. И каждый пятый класс получает еще диплом для классного полка за хорошее, активное и замечательное участие в этом празднике. Спасибо! Отдельный диплом за смелость, потому что был выбран в сонет Шекспира. За старание и активность единственный представитель шестого класса мы выдадим Софии Генкиной. Аплодисменты. Соня, я тебя поздравляю. Дипломчик, если можно, тебе спасибо. Дипломчики, все дипломы, как только я поставлю печать, обязательно завтра на первом же уроке все раздам. Договорились?
Да.
Спасибо большое.